Hello everyone, today we are going to conduct another speaking test and I'll give you the detailed feedback in the end. So watch this video till end. Good morning.
Good morning, ma'am.
What is your full name?
My name is Purnima Anand.
Can I see your ID?
Yes, please, ma'am.
Do you work or are you a student?
Actually, professionally, I am not working anywhere, but I am giving home tuitions to special children, and recently I have completed BA in special education also.
All right. In this part one, I will ask you a few questions related to you. Let's talk about picnics. Do you like picnics?
Yes, I like picnics, and I go for picnics in my weekends, and whenever I feel free with my parents.
Do people in your country like picnics?
Yes, if I talk about India, in India people like picnic and they generally go for picnic and they prepare meal for the picnic at home only, and then they go in any garden or at any suitable place of their city for picnic.
Where do they go for a picnic?
If I talk about people of Chandigarh, in Chandigarh there is a Pinjore Gardens where people generally go for picnic, and it is the best place where we can spend our time with family.
Okay, let's talk about furniture. Do you have a lot of furniture?
Yes, at my home there are a lot of furniture, and like sofas, dining table and my study table as well.
Which is your favorite piece of furniture and why?
If I talk about my favorite piece of furniture, that is my dining table, because it is the place where at night we all family members sit together and share our day-to-day talks and share our feelings as well.
Have you given furniture as a gift to anyone?
No, ma'am. I haven't given any furniture for anyone.
Why so?
Because I have no choice. I don't know which type of furniture I should buy to give someone as a gift. So I don't have idea of stuff, furniture stuff.
Okay, let's talk about text messages. Do you send or receive text messages daily?
Yes, if I talk about various companies, various mobile company, I receive their text message about their newly plans. And I also send the text message to my friends to give any information to them.
Have you ever misunderstood a text message?
No, I haven't misunderstood any text message because I read it very carefully when I get any text message.
When do you think it is better to call rather than text?
When there is an important information, when we want to give that something like, for example, if I talk about my family, I want to convey that I am coming late at home, then I usually call them to convey this important information.
Okay, let's talk about being in a hurry. What do you do in a hurry?
Whenever I am in hurry and I have to reach somewhere at time, I generally skip my breakfast.
Do you think that doing things in a hurry is a good idea?
No, it is not good idea always, because sometimes things get destroyed when we are in hurry.
What should not be done in a hurry?
We should not drive fast in hurry.
Why?
Ma'am, because it may lead to accident and sometimes damage to our any vehicle we are driving through.
All right, in this part two, I will give you a cue card. You will have 1 minute to prepare on that topic and you have to speak for 1 to 2 minutes.
Okay.
And I can stop you in between.
Okay.
Fine? Here is your cue card. This is your paper and pencil.
Should I start the topic?
Yes.
Family plays a very essential role in our life. I too like my family, but if I talk about other family which I support, that is my neighbor family. I live in sector 35. They live adjacent to our house. They are very good people because they have always helped us in every difficulty. There are four members in their family. Like father is working as a doctor, mother is the housewife, and their both children are very well mannered, and they are studying. And I've never seen any, if I talk about their family, I've never seen any dispute in their family. They are very caring and help us in every difficulty. And they were very cordial also. They have the, not only with us so only, they have the cordial relationship with others also. And if I cite here my example, real example, that is 2 to 3 weeks back, my father was suffering from COVID. In that situation, they helped us and provided us with everything which we needed for our family, because that time no one was entertaining us, no one was talking with us in my locality. So they were the people who helped us, and today also they come at our house time to time to help us, or they ask from time to time if we need any help. So this is the family which I like the most.
Can I have paper pencil back?
Yes.
All right, in this part 3, I will ask you a few questions related to this topic.
Okay.
How important is family?
Family is very important for us, because in our every difficulty, family helps us. And especially if I talk about my parents, they help me in my every problem. And the best part of it, they don't expect anything in return.
What changes did you see in your family in last 5 years?
In last 5 years, I've seen some changes in my family. Like my father has retired, and my brother has just got married, and now there's the further planning that we are going to shift in another city also.
Are grandparents important in our family, and in what way?
Yes, grandparents plays a very pivotal role in our life, because they guide us in every problem. And the best part is they tell us about the wrongs and right, and intact our family with the moral values.
How do devices affect a family?
Yes, if I talk about various mobile phones and various other electronic gadgets, they have affected our family, because nowadays we like to busy by using mobile phones and other gadgets, and we don't spend time together.
Do grandparents always have good relationship with their grandchildren, and why?
Yes, grandparents, I feel, have a good relation with their grandchildren, because they like to spend their time with their grandchildren. They play with their grandchildren, and they guide us in every difficulty. And the most important thing is they tell the various moral values to their grandchildren.
What is a working parent's role during weekends?
During weekends, working parents generally like to spend their time with their children, and they go generally for dinner and various other lunch and for picnic also. They like to spend their time with their children.
Do you think parents should motivate their children to look after their grandparents, and why?
Can you repeat the question, ma'am?
Do you think parents should motivate their children to look after their grandparents?
Yes, parents should motivate their children to look after the grandparents, because grandparents are very old, and generally they are retired, and they need extra care. For that, parents should guide them and by take caring of them, and to look after them also whenever they feel they can.
All right, this is the end of your speaking test.
Okay, thank you.
Now I would like to give you your feedback. Your fluency was good. Overall, you were confident and it was a good speaking test. And you can score up to 7 bands in real IELTS exam. Okay, now I'll give the detailed feedback of this candidate. You will notice in this video the mistakes also. This candidate can score up to 7 band in real IELTS exam. Why she can't score more than 7 or 8? Because there were few mistakes. Though her fluency was good, she was confident and she was giving the correct answers. There were certain mistakes which I am going to point out in this video. Now you can see an introduction.
Because I have no choice, I don't know which type of furniture I should buy to give someone as a gift. So I don't have idea of stuff, furniture stuff.
When I asked her about any piece of furniture she has given to anyone as a gift, she was talking about that she had no idea about furniture, no stuff. She does not know what kind of stuff she can purchase. I think this was the wrong answer. The question was, has she given anyone furniture as a gift? So answer should be, she hasn't, or yes, she has. And why she does not like to give furniture as a gift? Then I asked her about doing things in hurry and what things we should not do in hurry and why we should not do things in hurry. She said, things get destroyed. You can see that in this section. Do you think that doing things in a hurry is a good idea?
No, it is not good idea always, because sometimes things get destroyed when we are in hurry.
Yes, she said things get destroyed. We can't say things get destroyed. We can say that when we do things in hurry, there are chances of mistakes. But things get destroyed was not the right sentence. And then when I gave her cue card of this to talk about family she knows, and she started with a memorized answer. You can see that
family plays a very essential role in our life. I too like my family, but if I talk about other family which I support, that is my neighbor family.
Then she said that family I support. This was wrong. The topic was family she knows, but not the family she supports. So it was wrong sentence again. And then when she was talking about that family helped them when her father was suffering from COVID-19, she said they help us. It was helped because it was in the past. She was talking about the past situation. And then she said they were cordial, and she corrected herself. And then she said they come time to time. Again she corrected herself. You can see that in this video.
And today also they come at our house time to time to help us, or they ask from time to time if we need any help.
There is no harm if a candidate corrects himself or herself. Rather, it's good. But if you are correcting again and again, you show that you are not comfortable with the language. Though she was fluent and confident, but she was correcting herself again and again. It looks like she was looking for words, what to say and what to not. So make sure you do not do these mistakes in your exam. I hope this review will help you to get ideas how to score more in IELTS speaking. For more videos like this, do not forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you.